Hey YouTube, I'm back with another video. This is a mega volume tutorial. Right now I'm washing my client's lashes. I wash, prime, and seal all my clients. I believe it helps with retention, especially washing your client's lashes because, you know, you just never know. So, and even if they did, you know, on the way there, it's hot outside, they probably sweated or anything, and you don't want that to interfere with your retention or your lashes bonding to the natural lash. Wash off the soap and dry. Pats, don't rub your client's eye. Pat gently, because you're dealing with the eye and the eye is very sensitive, and make sure you're drying their eyelashes really good after washing. Right here, I am priming my client's eyelashes. I wash, dry, prime, then dry again. We're using Lion Lash eye pads today and an aftercare sensitive tape. I'm using a micro pore tape to lift my client's eyelid up a little bit off the aftercare sensitive tape so I don't get too many lashes sticking to the tape. You can use any tape to do this, it really doesn't matter. And we're going to use Soco tweezer for isolation, a straight tweezer, and Live Bay's Magic Mike tweezer for volume. I'm doing 10 mm in the inner corners, increasing to 12 mm, then 14 mm, then 16 mm, and then for the rest of it, 17 mm. I'm using 0.4 cc curl, I forgot to tell you guys. It's okay if you get your, you know, your fan stuck on your tweezers. That's just the reality of it. Things are going to happen. Just make sure you, you know, stick it on there. Brush it out good. Make sure nothing is stuck. Check with your mirror. I advise if you don't have one, get one. It really helps to check that everything is even. There's no spaces. And, to make sure both eyes are looking exactly the same. I'm not skipping around. I'm lashing every lash. This is a good way to make sure you get every lash. I don't have to tape back. I tried it. You'll see in the rest of the video. I tried to use the tape method, but it didn't really work for me. As long as I'm, you know, not skipping around, I can get everything. I can get every layer. Everything is exposed because the rest of the lashes are lashed in the front, and all I have to work with is no remaining lashes. But for this method, you do have to have a quick drying glue so you don't get as much stickies. But also, you need to be going back and checking your work. Like, you know, just move your tweezers throughout your lashes that you've lashed, making sure nothing is stuck. And as you see, I keep dropping my fans because I keep getting stuck in my tweezers. But that's okay because we're still in the beginning. Progress, progress. It's good to use both of your tweezers to isolate. You can really get every layer, like even the little lashes. You don't want to lash a baby lash, but you know, the hard to see lashes and everything. You can get everything. Just isolate really good. Isolation isn't that hard. You just have to do it. It's only hard when you're getting frustrated and you're just, you know, you're frustrated, so you're tiring yourself out and you're just thinking too much on it. But just do it and you'll have your isolation. If you caught on, I use my finger to isolate as well by pushing the lashes back. But you don't want to have any oils or anything on your hands. I always wash my hands before I lash my client, and I use hand sanitizer to kind of dry out my hands because I know I'm going to use them. And see how I'm checking my work? Yeah. And I tried doing this tape method, but it didn't work for me. It was kind of holding them in a way, holding her eyelid back in a way to where, I don't know, it was just kind of hard, I guess. I don't know, that was laying a type of way that I didn't. I don't know, but I took it off and I just continued doing what I was doing. Check your work, and it's okay if a lash comes off. Just put it back on there. It probably wasn't placed right. And you can still use that lash to, you know, put somewhere else. You don't want to waste your product if it's put together well. If you have a good fan, you don't want to waste that fan. Put that fan back on there. Also, I'm using clear glue. Because I was trying out Live Base clear adhesive, and I was just, you know, trying it to see how the retention was. It's a 1 to 2 second glue. I usually use a 0.5 second glue, but I felt like that glue was drying a little too fast for me. So, yeah. Right here, I am separating a lash that got stuck to another lash. When it comes to lashing, anything is correctable. So, you know, don't get discouraged. Don't get frustrated, especially while lashing a client, because it's just going to make you more tired. But everything is correctable. Like, it's so easy. It takes 2 to 3 seconds to correct. So, you know.
With the flea, Shawty, yeah, she bad, some tears and hips, yeah, she got pretty feet. Walking in this bitch in my pocket, yeah, they fat like a mound. I can't walk with this bitch on me. Yeah, I keep the heat on me.
R.P. Grinny, remember who it was? R.P. Quincy, go through hard times. Got my heart in my pocket. I can't take no more losses. No, no losses.
Got my mind confused. Give them the blue, love them with no clue. But the way I do it, shawty, yeah, she getting to me. Got my mind gone, taking these drugs, popping me down.
When doing a mega volume set, make sure you're lashing every lash, especially if they have a lot of lashes, because it's really going to make the set. You know, if they have a lot of lashes, it helps you make that mega volume set. So you want to lash every lash you can lash. And currently my prices are very low because I live in a small town. So I charge about $140 for this set. My set prices range from $80 to $140. And that's really, really cheap, you guys. Like, there's girls charging $250 for a mega volume set. But I do live in, you know, a semi-small town. So I have to go based off what everyone else is charging. But at the same time, I want to attract high-end clientele, so, you know, I charge my worth. If you're new at lashing, I would definitely pay attention to the details, like every little movement I'm making, pay attention to those exact details. It'll really help if you apply them when you're lashing a client. And then if you haven't lashed a client yet, you're still using your mannequin, it's very different when lashing a client. So I would advise you to watch this video, lash a client, and then rewatch it. Because that's what I did. I would watch YouTube videos, lash someone, and then I would rewatch it, because then I'm really paying attention to everything, because I, you know, went and tried to do it, and now I can actually understand what they're doing. And check your work, make sure everything is isolated, you didn't miss any lashes, nothing is stuck. I missed a lash right here, so I'm applying one. I'm gonna switch to a different angle. And I'm just going to let you guys enjoy the rest of the video. Pay attention to the details and, you know, just watch it over and over again. I promise you, you'll get it. This is just something that you have to practice to get. And also, my phone went dead, so I didn't get the end part of the video. But basically, I was finished and then I sealed my client's lashes with a lash bonder. And just like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know what you want to see. I'll make the video. You know what I'm saying? If you want to see more personal videos, how I get started with my day for clients, I'll definitely make that video. I'll make whatever you want to see. So, yeah. Oh, and give me some tips, you know, criticism. Let me know what you think I should have did differently. I'm still new. I've been lashing for 2 months, so I need all the tips and help, just like I'm trying to give it to y'all. And I will see you all in the next video.
She move, young and kicking shit, busting moves, walking through the beach, all eyes on me. Yeah, they see, no, I ain't getting coming with the game, coming with the flea. Shawty, yeah, she bad, had some tears and heels. Yeah, she got pretty feet. Walking in this bitch in my pocket, yeah, they fat like a mound. I can't walk with this bitch on me. Yeah, I keep the heat on me.
R.P. Grinny, remember who it was? R.P. Quincy, go through hard times. Got my heart in my pocket. I can't take no more losses. No.
Got my mind confused. Give him the blue, love him with no clue.
any downers. Don't know. Don't know what to do. All about my money. Don't play me for no fool. Shawty, yeah, she cute. Like the way she move. Young and kicking shit, bustin' moves. Walking through the beach, all eyes on me. Yeah, they see. Know I'm young and coming with the game. Coming with the flea. Shawty, yeah, she bad. Some tears and hips. Yeah, she got pretty feet. Walking in the beach in my pocket, yeah, they fat like a mile. I can't walk, cause this bitch on me. Yeah, I keep the heat on me,